بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم
الحمد لله رب العالمين والعاقبة للمتقين والصلاة والسلام على نبينا محمد وعلى آله وأصحابه أجمعين ومن تبعهم ودعا بدعوتهم وسلك مسلكهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين أما بعد أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم سبحانك لا علم لنا إلا ما علمتنا إنك أنت العليم الحكيم رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي ربي زدني علما Beloved viewers, my brothers and my sisters, Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. In the holy month of Ramadan, I'd like to welcome all of you into our program, Be a Good Muslim. With the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, we'll discuss in today's program with a topic called Connect Yourself with the Quran. My brothers and my sisters, my beloved viewers, as we all know that the holy month of Ramadan, it has a great connection with the holy book of Quran. As far as the holy Quran is concerned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decided to reveal the holy Quran to Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in the holy month of Ramadan. Therefore, Quran and Ramadan, they go neck to neck. They have a strong connection with one another. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in the holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم شهر رمضان الذي أنزل فيه القرآن هدى للناس وبينات من الهدى والفرقان. That month of Ramadan is that month where Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent the holy Quran. هدى للناس, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala calls Al-Quran as the guidance for the entire mankind. وَبَيِّنَاتٍ مِّنَ الْهُدَى وَالْفُرْقَانِ, and it's a clear evidence of guidance. وَالْفُرْقَانِ, and it's a divider between truth and false. My viewers, as far as Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is concerned, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is our creator. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be successful in this world. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants us to be successful in the hereafter. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, for our guidance, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has sent many, many messengers and prophets, alayhimu salatu wa salam. And to many of them, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has revealed his book and given his book. When the last and the final messenger of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam came, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and revealed to Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam the final book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the spoken words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is known as Al-Quran Al-Kareem, the Holy Quran, the Noble Quran. As far as Al-Quran Al-Kareem is concerned, it's the book of guidance. It gives us peace and tranquility and guidelines for this life and the hereafter, and how to please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and how to be succeeded in this life and in the hereafter, and how to have the salvation in this life and in the hereafter. Therefore, my brothers and my sisters, when the month of Ramadan comes, we have the golden opportunity to connect ourselves with the Holy Quran. Because Quran is the book which will rectify our characters. Quran is a book which will guide us. Quran is a book which will fulfill our needs. Quran is a book which will rectify our moralities. And Quran is a book which will make us the proper people, the good Muslim, the good believers, proper humans, which Allah and His beloved Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they want us to be. My brothers and my sisters, as far as the Holy Quran is concerned, Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is to study Quran, is to teach Quran, is to propagate Quran. However, that was the daily routine of Sayyiduna Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Sayyiduna Ali ibn Abi Talib radiallahu ta'ala anhu has said that in every moment of the day, Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will teach us Quran, and he will be busy and be occupied with teaching and propagating the message of the Quran to people. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has emphasized it so much. He has said to the ummah, "Ballighu anni walau ayah," that convey from me the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in form of Quran, even though if it is only one ayah, convey it to the people. But my brothers and my sisters, when the holy month of Ramadan is to come, Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to be really engaged with the holy Quran. Throughout the years, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to stand in night prayers with the holy Quran. And Sahaba, they have said that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to stand in the night prayers for such a long that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's legs used to get swollen. And when Sahaba used to question Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam that, "Ya Rasulullah, why do you stand such a long time in the night prayers with Quran?" Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to reply, "Afala akunu abdan shakura? Shall I not be a grateful servant of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala?" This was the custom, this was the sunnah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam throughout the year. But when the month of Ramadan used to come, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to stand in the night prayers during the nights of Ramadan. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, during the days of Ramadan, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to occupy himself in reciting the Holy Quran, in teaching the Holy Quran. And amazingly, in the holy month of Ramadan, one thing is to get additional in the schedule of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and that was Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam would descend, and Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam would do the muraja'a, will do the revision of the Holy Quran with Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Whatever has been revealed to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam up until then, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam will do the revision of it. He will revise it. He will do the muraja'a with Sayyiduna Jibreel alayhi salatu wa sallam. From there, my brothers and my sisters, we come to know that as far as the Holy Quran is concerned, we should connect ourselves with the Holy Quran. And this connection should remain with the Holy Quran throughout the year, 24/7, for the rest of our lives. But when the holy month of Ramadan is there, because the month of Ramadan is the month of training, month of Ramadan is the month of revision, month of Ramadan is the month when to revive our iman, to give a boost to our iman, to give a boost to our characteristics, to give a boost to our connection with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And as far as the Holy Quran is concerned, it plays a crucial role in order to have our connection strong with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore, in the holy month of Ramadan, we should strive and we should try our level best in order to renew our connection with the Holy Quran. How can we renew our connection with the Holy Quran? Number one, by reciting the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As far as the recitation of the Holy Quran is concerned, it's a great rewardable act. Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, a person who recites one letter of the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant that person minimum 10 rewards. And then Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, "La aqul," I don't say, "Alif lam mim," I in fact say, "Alifun harfun wa lamun harfun wa mimun harfun." That when we recite Alif Lam Mim, because we have recited three letters, so because of that, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will, for each letter, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will give us the minimum rewards, which is 10. As far as the teaching and learning is Quran is concerned, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, "Khayrukum man ta'allama al-Qur'ana wa 'allama." The best amongst you are those who learn Quran and teach it to other. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to receive Quran from Allah Ta'ala. He used to learn it from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to convey it, and he used to teach it to the Sahaba Ridwanullahi alayhi majma'in. Therefore, he has said, "Khayrukum man ta'allama al-Qur'ana wa 'allama." My brothers and my sisters, as far as the Quran is concerned, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had really strong attachment in the Holy Quran. Sahaba, they had really strong attachment to the Holy Quran. The followers of the Sahaba, they had the strong attachment to the Holy Quran. And the entire ummah, all the pious people from the ummah of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they had a strong connection with the Holy Quran. Why? Because Quran is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Quran is the spoken words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Quran is a book. When we are more embracing towards it, when we are more close to Quran, when we are more connected to Quran, then Quran will guide us towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, towards our master, towards our creator, towards our beloved Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The Sahabi who narrates this hadith from Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. His name is Sayyiduna Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu ta'ala an. Sayyiduna Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu ta'ala an, he is the richest sahabi. He is the richest companion of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. It said regarding his shahada, that day he became shaheed, that even in that day as well, Sayyiduna Uthman ibn Affan radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was reciting Holy Quran. And when he was killed and assassinated, Sayyiduna Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu was reciting the verse of the Holy Quran as فَسَيَكْفِيكَهُمُ wa huwa السَّمِيعُ الْعَلِيمُ. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala should be sufficient for them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all hearing, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is all knowing. The student who narrated this hadith from Sayyiduna Uthman radiyallahu ta'ala anhu, his name is Abu Abdurrahman As-Sulami rahimahullah. Regarding Abu Abdurrahman As-Sulami rahmatullahi alayhi, Hafiz ibn Hajar al-Asqalani rahmatullahi alayhi, he has written in Fathul Bari, the commentary of Sahih al-Bukhari, that Abu Abdurrahman As-Sulami rahmatullahi alayhi has taught Quran for 72 years. 72 years this man occupied himself with the Holy Quran. He has taught Holy Quran. And then he is to say that inna hadha al-Quran aq'adani hadha al-muqam, that this is the great book Quran which has put me into this high place, that he taught Quran in Mecca, he taught Quran in Kufa, he taught Quran in Basra, in those great cities of Islam in those days, and he had thousands of students all over the place. So as a tahdith bin ni'mah, as confessing the greatness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and his bounties, Abu Abdurrahman As-Sulami rahmatullahi alayhi is to say, this is the great book Al-Quran Al-Kareem which has put me into this high position. So therefore, my brothers and my sisters, as far as the Holy Quran is concerned, it's the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, it's the spoken words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more we are connected with the Holy Quran, we are connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and the more we are connected with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will support us, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will assist us, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will guide us towards our main destiny, which is Jannatul Firdaus, which is the Jannah, which is the place where we originally lived with our parents, Sayyiduna Adam and Hawa alayhim as-salatu was-salam, and from there we originate, and there inshallah we will be going with the will of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And above everything, my brothers and my sisters, once we have connected ourselves with the Holy Quran, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love us. And once Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will love us, Allahu Akbar, we don't need anything else, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said in the Holy Quran, وَرِضْوَانٌ مِّنَ اللَّهِ أَكْبَرٌ, that the pleasure of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is the greatest of all the bounties. When Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with somebody, he or she, they don't need anything, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is there for them, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is pleased with them. Therefore, in the ahadith, Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has mentioned many benefits of the Holy Quran. One of the benefits of the Holy Quran, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said that the servants, they cannot draw nearness to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala but with something which came out from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, i.e. Holy Quran. Because the Holy Quran, they are the spoken words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah spoke to Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam, and Jibreel alayhi salatu wa salam brought the Holy Quran to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Therefore, Quran is the spoken words of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam has said, anyone needs to have Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with him and to be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, then the easiest procedure, the easiest method is to recite the Holy Quran, is to ponder into Holy Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, أَفَلَا يَتَدَبَّرُونَ الْقُرْآنِ, don't the people ponder in the Holy Quran. لَوْ كَانَ فِيهِمَا آلِهَةٌ غَيْرُ اللَّهِ لَفَسَدَتَ, that the Quran will indicate to people towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the ultimate being, the only one, the real one, which is Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has said, سَنُرِيهِمْ آيَاتِنَا فِي الْآفَاقِ وَفِي أَنفُسِهِمْ حَتَّى يَتَبَيَّنَ لَهُمْ أَنَّهُ الْحَقِّ, that we will show them our signs in the horizons, and these horizons and these signs and all these things in this universe, they will lead them towards Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, which is the universal truth. So as far as the Holy Quran is concerned, it's the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It will guide us to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And once we have believed in the Holy Quran, once we have practiced the commands of Holy Quran, we will be living our life peacefully in this world, and Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will grant us peace in the hereafter. My brothers and my sisters, there comes an incident in one of the hadith of Jami' al-Tirmidhi. A sahabi comes to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he said, Ya Rasulullah, once I was in a journey and I did not realize that there was a grave. And I, by mistake, made my tent on a grave. And when I was there, Ya Rasulullah, from the grave I could hear that a person was reciting Quran. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said, yes, as far as the Holy Quran is concerned, and this person was reciting Suratul Mulk. Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam has said that as far as the Holy Quran is concerned, if somebody recites Holy Quran and Suratul Mulk, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will protect them from the punishment of grave. My brothers and my sisters, as far as the Holy Quran is concerned, Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam was so much connected to the Quran. Sahaba explained how Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to recite the Holy Quran. Our beloved mother Sayyida Umme Salama radiallahu ta'ala anha, one of the wives of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam, she explains that when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to recite the Holy Quran, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to recite Holy Quran so clearly, harfan harfan, that each and every letter of the Holy Quran could be understood. And Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam used to recite very clearly. Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu ta'ala anhu used to say that do not make the end of the surah your ambition. In fact, try to recite the Quran with the proper and the correct recitation of the Holy Quran, with the proper tajweed of the Holy Quran, and with the ponder. My brothers and my sisters and my elders and my beloved viewers, as far as the Holy Quran is concerned, Quran is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, was revealed to us for our guidance. And Quran is such a beautiful book that in the beginning of the book, Quran gives us the assurance that ذَلِكَ الْكِتَابُ لَا رَيْبَ فِي, that is the book which has no doubt in it. It's from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is no doubt in it. The more we read it, the more we are connected to it, the more we are embracing the Holy Quran, it is better for us. It is good for us. Quran has many rights. Quran has many beauties. One of the rights of the Quran is that we recite the Holy Quran. And when we recite the Holy Quran, we recite Quran, وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. We recite the Quran in a very beautiful and in the accurate procedure of reciting the Holy Quran, which is known as tajweed. Allah's Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam has been ordered by Allah Ta'ala, and through him, the entire ummah, وَرَتِّلِ الْقُرْآنَ تَرْتِيلًا. Second rite of the Quran we have, that we listen to the Holy Quran. When the beautiful recitation of the Holy Quran is taking place, we listen to the Holy Quran. فَإِذَا قُرِيَ الْقُرْآنُ فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ وَأَنْسِتُوا لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ. When the Holy Quran is recited, فَاسْتَمِعُوا لَهُ, listen very attentively, وَأَنْسِتُوا, and keep quiet, لَعَلَّكُمْ تُرْحَمُونَ, so that you may have the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Just listening to the Quran, it makes us eligible to have the mercy of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to listen to Quran from other sahaba, and he used to love listening it to other people. Once Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam went to Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu, and he said, Abdullah, can you recite a portion of Quran to me? Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu replied, Ya Rasulullah, am I going to recite Quran to you? Well, the Quran is revealed on you. Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam replied that I love to listen to Quran from someone else. Sayyiduna Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu says, I started to recite Quran in front of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. When I came to this ayat of Surah An-Nisa, فَكَيْفَ إِذَا جِئْنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ بِشَهِيدٍ وَجِئْنَا بِكَ عَلَى هَؤُلَاءِ شَهِيدًا. That was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, what will be the horrific scenario and the scary scenario of the Day of Judgment? فَكَيْفَ إِذَا جِئْنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ بِشَهِيدٍ. When we will resurrect a witness from all the nations, we'll resurrect them and we'll bring them forward, and they will confess to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that, wa Allah, we have conveyed your message to these people. Some of them listened and many of them never listened. وَجِئْنَا بِكَ عَلَى هَؤُلَاءِ شَهِيدًا. And on the day of resurrection, we'll brought you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. We'll bring you, O Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in front of the entire humanity, entire children of Adam alayhi salatu wa sallam. And Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, you will be giving testimony regarding the commands of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, that the messengers of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the prophets of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, they conveyed the message of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to their nations. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiallahu anhu said that when I recited this verse of the Holy Quran to Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَكَيْفَ إِذَا جِئِنَا مِنْ كُلِّ أُمَّةٍ بِشَهِيدٍ وَجِئِنَا بِكَ عَلَىٰ هَؤُلَاءِ شَهِيدًا. When I raised my eyes, subhanallah, what I see is that Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's eyes, tahmilan or tadrifan, in two different ahadith, two different words been used by Abdullah ibn Mas'ud. He has said, suddenly I saw Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam's, both of the eyes of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they're shedding tears. So my brothers and my sisters, as far as the Holy Quran is concerned, it's the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The more we are connected to the Holy Quran, it is better for us. Spiritually we'll develop. Our spirituality will be boosting. Our iman will be boosting. We'll be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll be close to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. We'll be beloved to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Sayyiduna Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, when he is to recite the Holy Quran, in tahajjud prayers, Allahu Akbar, sahaba then narrate, Lahu azizun ka azizil mirjali. When Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is to recite the Holy Quran in the night prayers, Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is to have this sound, which normally when the rice is cooked on a pot, and when the rice is about to be fully cooked, and the water is bubbling, and it has a sound on the pot, Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to have that sound coming out from his stomach. Sayyida Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha, the beloved wife of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, she said, our Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam used to ponder so much with the Holy Quran, and he used to recite so much Holy Quran in Salah, that one night Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam spent the entire night standing in the night prayers, just reciting one ayat of the Holy Quran, which is, إِن تُعَذِّبْهُمْ فَإِنَّهُمْ عِبَادُكُ وَإِن تَغْفِرْ لَهُمْ فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. That if you punish the people, then of course you have the rights, because they are your servants. And if you are forgiving them, O Allah, then there is no one to ask you. فَإِنَّكَ أَنْتَ الْعَزِيزُ الْحَكِيمُ. Because you are all powerful and you are full of wisdom. So my brothers and my sisters, my beloved viewers, in the holy month of Ramadan, let's take a U-turn towards the Holy Quran. Let's go back to the Holy Quran. Let's embrace the Holy Quran. Let's try to recite the Holy Quran as it should be recited. Let's try to understand the Holy Quran as it should be understood. Let's try to practice the Holy Quran as it should be practiced. And let's try to propagate the Holy Quran as it should be propagated. Quran has many rights upon us. Number one, to recite. Number two, to understand. Number three, to practice. And number four, to propagate the Holy Quran to the people of this world. Therefore, in this holy month of Ramadan, my brothers, my sisters, we have the golden opportunity to listen to Quran in the night prayers, in the Tarawih prayers. We can recite Quran by ourselves. Make a habit of reciting Quran in this holy month of Ramadan, because the month of Ramadan is the time for training, spiritually training. So therefore, whatever we train here in this month of Ramadan, for the remaining 11 months, we'll be practicing accordingly. So therefore, in the holy month of Ramadan, make a habit of reciting Holy Quran correctly, understanding the Holy Quran, practicing the Holy Quran, and then finally propagate the Holy Quran. Remember, Sahaba, they have took Quran, and they have embraced Quran, and they have practiced Quran. Therefore, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has declared in the Holy Quran, radiyallahu anhum wa radu an, that Allah ta'ala is pleased with them, and they are pleased with us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala may declare the same for us as well, if we are the people who are embracing Quran. We are reading Quran, we are understanding Quran, we are practicing Quran, and we are propagating Quran in this holy month of Ramadan. Let's make a commitment for Quran and promise to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala that we will reconnect ourselves with the holy Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant us all the blessings of Ramadan. And may Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala grant the humanity all the best in this world and in the next life. Barakumullah, salamu alaykum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Mm-hmm.